gorgeous four country siblings from Cedar Town. I'm sure you guys know where Cedar Town is. It's hours away, right?
I just came from there.
Okay. So you, I heard you. Like, someone was saying, why are you weren't here or something? You're like, I had to work. Yeah, I get it. But thank you guys so much for having us. Tonight we just want to worship with you guys. We just want to play some songs that we enjoy and are blessed by, and we hope that you guys are too. And I know some have already heard that earlier, but we're going to play one more that I think a few of you guys have heard. It's called What a Friend. We have a friend in Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. We are Scarlet, and a lot of people think that that's like a clothing store until they actually hear us like singing and playing. We're like, no, because one guy, he's like, so is that like a clothing store? Like, do you sell like wool coats? And I was like, blush. I was so blood red, like very embarrassed. I'm like, no, we're a band and we sing. And I was like, how do you think that's a clothing store? But I guess the wool thing. But Hannah does make some. By the way, this is Hannah. She makes the scarves and things out there. She also plays guitar. And she plays this foot tambourine thing, so we don't have, our hands are full, so we can't shake a tambourine, so she kicks it instead. But not like this, you know what I mean? It's like a foot pedal. And this here girl, playing little mandolin, she's new. We kind of threw her into the group around Christmas time. We just got back from Northern Ireland, and we had some Christmas gigs. And I was like, man, I know you love the ukulele, and that's like your main instrument. I know you love it, but I don't know how I'm supposed to mix ukulele with Christmas music. I just don't know how I'm supposed to do it. And so I said, well, I pretty much told her anyway. I'm like, you're going to have to pick up the mandolin and play with us during the Christmas season. So she so graciously picked up a new instrument, and I kind of made her. But I'm kind of used to doing that. I'm the eldest of six, so I'm kind of used to being bossy and everybody just kind of doing what I say. No. But this is Leah Flamore on the mandolin. And over here, Mr. Quiet, he never says anything until you make him mad. But then you would really have to make him mad for him to, like, speak his mind. This is Matthew here on the cajon. A lot of people don't know what this is that he's playing because it's a fairly new instrument, especially in the Christian realm, but it's called cajon. And so it's not just a seat, my friends. It is an instrument. And I'm Tabitha. I sometimes forget to introduce myself. Once I get done introducing them, I forget myself. And they won't speak and introduce me, so then I have to do it myself. But, oh goodness. I'm going to stop rambling. So let's sing some songs.
Thank you, God.
Thank you.
we can take it to the Lord in prayer. I know sometimes, even as Christians, we kind of forget that. We know that He's there and that He hears us, but we like forget because sometimes we go on our feelings, and if God doesn't feel close, or we just kind of think He's not there. But He is, and everything that we're going through, we can tell Jesus. I mean, we have Him in, He has us in His hands. He has us in His hands. I'm going to get this right. I am dyslexic. And we forget that sometimes. Life gets busy, things go on, you know, school, and we forget that God's got us in His hands. He's with us. And so we've just got to kick those feelings in the butt, so to speak, and say, Lord, I know You're with me. I know that You hear me, and You're going to help me through this. So we want to sing a song that's called Your Hands, and it's just declaring that God is in, God, we are in His hands. I'm going to get this right, folks. So just remember that tonight.
Mm-hmm.
know that friendship and that love and that intimacy that we can have with him. And I know that a lot of churches are so big on going to mission trips outside of the United States, and that's great, but we've got to do some mission work here in our own country. So we want to sing you guys. We like to take hymns and kind of rearrange them and make them our own. And we had a lot of calls come from coffee shops and festivals. And we thought, well, instead of just going and like singing like the oldies, like Jolene and Looking Out My Back Door, those are great, but what songs can we sing that would minister to folks sitting there? And we thought of hymns, but we didn't want to sing them the original way because we didn't want to scare people away. We wanted to draw them in. And so Hannah and I were at the old Vanwerk church, and we were just fooling around, and we started playing this melody. And it turned into Be Thou My Vision. So we want to play these songs for you and just remind you guys that we each have a talent. I know sometimes it feels like we don't, but we do. And whatever God has given us, we have to use it to glorify him and to minister to others and be witnesses. And this is just kind of our way of doing that.
Be thou my vision, O Lord.
about suicide earlier, and I just want to share this story. A lot of you probably have experienced the feeling of it. I know it's becoming very popular, sadly, that people are choosing to end their life. And I know a lot of you probably have been affected by it or know someone who has been affected by it. But about 3 years ago, we were on our way to Northern Ireland, the day before, actually, and my sisters and I were roaming at a coffee shop, Swift and Finch, our favorite, and we get a call from our parents, and they told us, don't answer any of your calls, don't look at your text message, we want you to come home right now, and we knew something was up, and so we sped home. And the whole time I'm thinking, oh my gosh, you know, what is going on? Because, I mean, that was enough for me. I'm a worrywart, and I was just freaking out the whole way home. And I remember opening the door, and my mom said, your cousin committed suicide. And my heart, man, it just dropped. It was the worst feeling I've ever felt in my life. And, we've got to do stuff, folks. We've got to be witnesses. I know it's easy for us to just kind of hide our light, but if we're lights, you know, someone could come up to us and say, well, you know, what do you have that I don't? Or if we notice someone's acting strange, they're acting strange, instead of just kind of distance ourselves from them because we're like, man, they're weird. Why not walk up to them and be like, how are you today? You know, what's going on in your life? And I mean, I'm not saying that we all got to be like Jesus, Jesus everywhere and like be the, you know, wear Jesus shirts. But just little things like that, just walking up to someone or just talking with people, having real conversations, getting our heads out of our homes, you know, realizing things that are happening around us. There are people hurting. And I felt guilty because I didn't do that. I knew my cousin was in drugs. I knew he was hanging around the wrong kind of folk. And what did I do? I distanced myself from him instead of being a light in his life. Instead of, you know, saying, hey, Alec, you want to go out? Let's go bowling or something. Let's do something. You know, giving him a day away from the drugs, away from the bad friends to see what life could be like without them. And we went on to our mission trip, but while we were there, like all the kids we were ministering to, I just would see my cousin's face. It's like kind of like you see in movies how they like see that person in the crowd. I literally was experiencing that, and I would just bawl. I'd run into the bathroom and just bawl because I was so full of guilt that I didn't do anything about it. I didn't do my part. And I was just crying to the Lord, like, what can I do? I'm not this great speaker. I'm not this great singer. I'm not this great, you know, social butterfly. But what can I do to be a witness to someone, to help someone? And he literally gave me this song. I'm not a writer. My siblings know, my family knows, like, that's not what I do. Our former lead singer, that was what she did. And my point in saying that is, we think that we can't do something, but if we allow God to use us, we will be so surprised at what he can do through us when we let him. And so I just want to sing this song. It's called This Is My Child. And if you're hurting, if you're out there and you're hurting, maybe it's you tonight and your experience and thoughts that you're not good enough. You are good enough. Maybe you're experiencing thoughts tonight that there will be no peace. Well, there is peace in God. Maybe you're someone here tonight that thinks you're not good enough. You are good enough. Maybe you're someone here tonight that thinks no one will love me for who I am. God loves you. He sent his son for you. There is a better way, and ending your life is not. Amen. Amen.
Oh,
Agnes, we're going to sing one more. And I think my dad, he's going to come and do the invitation if you were ready. But I just hope that we've encouraged you in some way tonight to use your gift for him. He's a good, good God, and he deserves all of our praise and all of our glory. And that's today, if you want to. Changing up, Daddy. This is going to be the altar. If you want to come up.
Leave here tonight if you don't know. And if you are saved, but you know, maybe there's a lot of things that ain't right in your life. You know, we've stepped away and walked in the wrong, in the opposite direction of what we know we should be doing. We can never walk too far away from the Lord. We can never be out of His grasp. If we just humble ourselves and come before Him and just cry out to Him, He'll restore us to where we need to be. And put that peace back in our heart. So as I play this last song, if any of y'all feel led, come up here, pray and seek. Like I say, there's no special formula. You don't even have to come up here. You can pray right where you're at. The Lord hears you, and He sees your heart, and He hears the words directly from your heart. But by doing so, by coming forward or coming to a person afterwards, that's just a show of faith. That's a declaration that we made a decision to share that with somebody. So pray where you're at. Pray, come forward and ask someone to pray with you. Any of us will be happy to pray with you. Let's play this last song.
store.